That said, I need to just take a political pause. And I'm joined now by iconic political figure and best-selling New York Times best-selling author, Roger Stone. Roger, welcome back to New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Bill, great to be with you.
So I have to ask you, Roger, what happened last night? Is this thing over? And do you expect now that Donald Trump is just going to surge to the 1237 and all this talk of a brokered convention is done?
It appears that way. He is 174 votes short of a majority. The only candidate left in the race is John Kasich with 158. Trump now hovering around 1,000. I think this race is fundamentally over, and the next race has begun.
Yeah.
The ultimate confrontation between he and crooked Hillary.
Now, let me ask you this, Roger. So let's talk about New Jersey. Last time I had you on, we were talking about how New Jersey could have been a pivotal state if Ted Cruz had stayed in after Indiana. But once you get a thumping of 20 points, it's hard to justify staying in. And the question is, If Donald Trump's poll numbers stay the way they are, where he's about 30 points up in the last poll in the Republican primary, that lead will grow. Obviously, if nobody's in, he'll win all of it. But how does that play in a general election? Because I think there's a lot of folks in New Jersey and New York who are looking at the general saying, does Donald Trump make New Jersey a competitive state for the Republicans in a general election?
Well, I don't want to be sanguine about it. It's a blue state. It's a very uphill state. But I think you might have, because of Trump's long history in the state, because the state is contiguous with New York, I think New Jersey is going to be in play. It's not easy, but the entire campaign is not easy. Trump is trailing Hillary Clinton very narrowly at this point. But polls are just a snapshot in time, and these numbers are going to change very dramatically. The fact that Bernie Sanders has, in my opinion, not hit Hillary Clinton on her areas of greatest vulnerability, and therefore her unfavorable ratings are somewhat recessed, that's going to change now very dramatically. This is going to be one of the closest, most hard-fought campaigns in American history, and I think New Jersey will be in play.
Wow, it'd be amazing. I mean, as far as from a New Jersey perspective, that would be incredible to see that instead of it just being a gimme in one column or the other. Let me ask you this about the VP sweepstakes. Governor Christie the other day talked about his cell phone and how the defendants in Bridgegate wanted to take a look at it. And he essentially said, look, I have no problem with that. We'll do, you know, we go through the process as we have to go through it. I saw that as a sign having nothing to do with Bridgegate and everything to do with the fact that it's very possible he's being vetted for vice president. What do you think?
Well, geographically, that makes very little sense. I think Governor Christie's a good man, and I think he's been very, very helpful to the Trump juggernaut here. He saw things that no one else saw several months ago when, unlike the other competitors, he dropped out of the race and endorsed Donald Trump. In the end of the day, of course, I see him as a more likely Homeland Security director, perhaps Attorney General. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure that candidates from New York and New Jersey make a lot of sense, in the Midwest and the far West.
Who do you think he picks if you had to bet today? Is it Kasich?
It's a wide open question. I mean, right now he has, of course, greater latitude and leverage than he's ever had. He doesn't need to make a deal. How about General Mike Kelly?
There you go.
How about somebody from outside the realm of politics?
Yeah. Well, it's interesting. There'll certainly be more to talk about as we get closer, and I always appreciate your insight and your expertise on this, Roger. Thank you for joining me this morning. We will be talking very soon, I'm sure.
Great to be with you, Bill, and go out right now and buy 100 copies of my book, would you?
There you go. The title of the book, Roger, is Jeb and the Bush Crime Family.
Well, but more relevant at this point is The Clinton's War on Women.
The Clinton's War.
RogerStone.com.
All right. You know what? I'll tweet that out. You can buy that on Amazon, right?
Yes, indeed.
Yeah, you got it, Roger. All right. Great talking to you. We'll talk soon. Take care.
Thanks.
All right. Bye. 7:56 on New Jersey 101.5. This thing is going to heat up in a very exciting way. And, Roger is an interesting guy because he's written best-selling books on the New York Times bestseller list. And he's gone after all of the political establishment. He's gone after the Clintons and the Bushes equally, which I find very fascinating. So interesting stuff to come.